Welcome to the Soul of Enterprise, Business and the Knowledge Economy. We are here live, folks, from IPBC's Ignite 2016 conference, and we'll be doing interviews all day today and tomorrow. And we're absolutely honored, our first interview right out of the gate. I'm really honored to be able to talk to her. She is the founder, Ed, of the IPBC.
I know.
And she founded it back in January of 2007, so it's coming up on 10 years. So, Dianne Mueller, welcome to the Soul of Enterprise.
Hi, I'm really happy to be here. Yes, 10 years almost.
Wow. I've been to all five of your conferences. Love it. Love this whole community. Just think what you guys do great work here, and you've really put bookkeeping on the map, and I think, you know, really professionalized it. So tell us the story of founding this organization.
Well, sure. Actually, it's funny that you use the word professional, because that was really the reason behind starting the association. It's all I've ever done. 25 years at that point. So I guess that means coming up on 35 years is bookkeeping. And you know, just sitting in my own little office all by myself, not a whole lot of interaction going on. I needed to speak to other people. I wanted to grow my business. I wanted to know the ways that they were doing it. And I really wanted a association that was going to be very professional. I used to call them the kitchen table bookkeepers. I think I've been quoted as saying that quite a few times, that I would come up across all the time, and I just thought, how are we ever going to be respected out there? How are we ever going to be able to get the rates and fees that we deserve if we've got a lot of people out there that think it's an easy thing to do, and it's not an easy thing to do. So myself, and I actually was belonging to a very small organization at that point, that I thought could be more professional, could actually do a lot to further the cause, kind of thing. So myself and two other bookkeepers decided that we would start an association that actually had the word professional in it. And that's how we came up with the Institute of Professional Bookkeepers of Canada, to actually put ourselves separate from the kitchen table bookkeepers. And that's where certified professional bookkeeper came from too. It was just really, really important for me to be professional. Yeah. So that was back in 2007, and certainly we've had our ups and downs. It's a nonprofit, completely volunteer organization when it got started, and then it grew, and we knew we wanted to add staff, and rest is history.
Well, why bookkeeping, though? What attracts you, Dan, to bookkeeping? Why bookkeeping?
You know, that's a really good question, because I have a passion that is so strong, that burns inside me for small business. It's the backbone of the economy, and it really comes from loving small business and the heroes out there that actually do everything that they can on a daily basis to make their businesses work and ultimately keep us all employed. So it really is about small business as to why I do bookkeeping.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe you could tell us a story about a situation that you've been involved in where either yourself as a bookkeeper or one of the bookkeepers that you know has had a significant impact on someone's business or their life even.
Right, and that's a daily occurrence, right? I mean, I have a lot of clients that they become so dependent on me that they really feel like they couldn't run their business without me. And gosh, over the 25, 30 years that I've been doing this, that happens all the time. And it's great when you can look on my website and you can see all the testimonials, and they're all the same. It's like, we couldn't do this without her. She runs the business. She got us through the last audit. You know, all of those scary things that happen every single day in a business for a small business owner, when Canada Revenue Agency, for example, calls up and says they're coming in. And so there's a lot of business owners out there that are incredibly grateful for bookkeepers, and they become that trusted advisor, which we've always been. It's just now become that the rest of the world is recognizing us as that.
No, it's so true, because the bookkeepers are at the coalface. You have the relationship day by day, and you're out there holding their hands. And
absolutely. And I'm often asked, you know, one of the things that I do a lot is volunteer at Small Business BC, which is a government-funded organization to actually help small businesses get off the ground. So I do a seminar there every single month on the things that they need to be looking at and doing their first year in business. And that's the one thing that we're always talking about. You know, how do you actually take a business from startup, the day one, through to the next, you know, year and all of the things that they need to do? And we hold their hand through all of that because it's all so new to them. They have the great idea. They have the passion out there to build their business, but they don't know how to do it. So when they've got somebody sitting right beside them looking after all of that compliance and regulation and red tape that they most entrepreneurs don't like anyways, then they're pretty grateful that someone can do that. And oftentimes one of the questions is, do I hire an accountant or do I hire a bookkeeper? Well, the correct answer is, of course, both. But they want to know the difference. They don't even know the differences between an accountant and a bookkeeper. So they go in thinking they need an accountant when what they really do is need a bookkeeper. And the person that's doing that day to day, every single day in their books, in their business, putting out the fires, teaching them how to do it, talking to the regulators for them, they pretty quickly learn that the end of the year, they're not the bookkeeper is the one that they need to be dealing with on a day-to-day basis.
So how about a story of something that you've done inside your practice, either, you know, your personal practice or IPBC, even if you wanted to broaden it out, that has made you guys more successful?
I guess building up the self-esteem of bookkeepers is probably, I think, the most, certainly the thing that I try to do every single day that I'm involved with IPBC, because they need to know that they are the people out there that are running small businesses and keeping the economy moving. So when they get that, then all of a sudden they can stand up, you know, sit up straighter and realize the contribution that they make. So that is really, I think, the most important thing I'm contributing.
Why do you think that is? What's the self-esteem issue?
I think that comes from, it was always looked at something that anybody could do. Didn't have to have any special skills. You didn't have to have a real business background to do a debit and credit kind of thing. I think, truthfully and frankly, I think accountants tend to keep us away from certain things that they want to do. So they kind of put that message out there that if it's important, then they have to do it or want to be involved in it. I'm not quite sure where it came from, but it's certainly something that's been a long, long time in our history, and I'd had enough about it.
Dianne, we've been here for a couple of days now at the conference and listening to the great speakers. Ed did a pre-conference yesterday, and we've heard about the firm of the future and probably going to hear about the firm of the now a little bit later today from Sage. What do you think are the greatest opportunities facing the bookkeeping profession?
Oh, there's so many right now. You know, I always use this analogy that I can remember back when desktop first came on and everybody was saying, oh gosh, there goes our jobs. It's just us computers, right? You know, we go into London Drugs and we can see the QuickBooks box on the end of the aisle in the Simply Accounting at that point, Sage, and everybody's going to be able to do it themselves. And completely the opposite thing has happened. They didn't want to do it themselves. They couldn't even install the software onto the desktop. And again, that's not who business owners are. As general, if you're going to go into business, you're not a detailed person. Now, I know that's generalization, but typically that's not what you want to do.
You're a creator, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yep. So that's not what they want to do. Even if they do try to do it, within a year they're realizing that I don't really want to do it, even if I can do this. So, yeah, I don't know. I think I got off on that and forgot your actual question.
No, that's fine. So with all this technology, you're not worried about it threatening the role of the bookkeeper.
I'm totally not worried at all.
You're an
optimist.
Because
my clients, and my clients don't hire me because I know how to run Sage 50. That's not anywhere in the conversation when I'm going in and seeing a brand new client. We're talking about their business, their issues, where they want to take the business, how they want to grow. That's the conversations that we're having. It's not ever about how the data gets in there. Right. Never is that right. A part of the conversation I would have for a client. So I think that I'm not worried at all. Doesn't even affect my business, because that's really what I've been doing anyways for the last 25 years, is that business advisor. I think one of the other things I do want to do for a lot of the bookkeepers here at IPBC is to teach them how to come up with those services, because that's the other thing that's happened, is they think about debits and credits only, and that their place has always been to do that data entry. That's not their place. That's never been their place. So again, getting that message across to every one of them, and I think we're making huge headways there.
Absolutely.
For sure. So having them think about it in a different perspective and not go in there saying, well, the first question out of their mouth is, what software do you use? Or what software do you want to use? That shouldn't even be in the conversation. It doesn't really matter in that sense what software it is. It's which one's going to work best for you and how and what's coming out.
I would imagine, though, that you know we have 300 bookkeepers or so at this conference here, and how many members do you have across Canada?
Just under 1,500.
1,500, but that's not the be-all and end-all. There's got to be way more than 1,500 bookkeepers in total
that's
in Canada, right?
That's right.
So what would you say to someone who's listening to this podcast, perhaps retrospectively, on why they should really be part of IPBC?
Bookkeepers unite.
I love it.
Bookkeepers of the world unite.
Absolutely.
Of Canada, anyway.
Absolutely. That's right. You know, we want to be the best out there. We want to be the professionals out there. And we want to change the perspective of who we are, because we're running a lot of what moves the economy on an every day-to-day basis. So we need to be recognized for that.
Mm-hmm.
Businesses that start up, we all know the statistics, so many of them are not around in 5 years' time. We can make a difference there. We can make sure that they're around in 5 years' time. We can grow the economy more than anybody else out there. That's power.
Mm-hmm.
It is.
And power that needs to be recognized.
So when you think about the leverage the bookkeeper has with, you know, 40, 50, 100 customers they may have, it's amazing that knowledge can be leveraged out to all those businesses.
And what can that do to the economy if we actually make a lot more of those businesses successful?
Yeah,
right.
That's powerful. I have to ask you, Dianne, you were awarded the Luca Pacioli Award in 2014, and I think you went to London to receive it.
I did.
Tell me what that was like, because here's the father of double entry bookkeeping.
I know. It was surreal, and I can remember when we announced it at the IPBC conference. Gosh, I guess it's over two years ago now, that I had been awarded this international award. And, you know, to be really truthful and honest about it, it's not about any awards for me. It's really about what I can do for the professional bookkeeper and the people that work so hard every single day out there helping small businesses. So it's about the economy. And I was, of course, very thrilled and that they would choose me to actually receive such a prestigious award. But it's not about awards.
I totally get that. Yeah. I totally get that. But nobody more deserving than you, because you really have put this profession on the map, at least in Canada, and I just hope it keeps rolling over.
Oh, it's going to. It's going to.
Well, I have an exit question that I like to ask all the guests that I ever interview, and you actually mentioned this word earlier, so I'm going to actually give an exclusion, right?
Yeah.
Other than all of the professional bookkeepers that you help and you've worked with, who is a hero of yours, and why are they a hero?
I would have to tell you, a very close friend is a hero of mine. Well, I actually have two, I have to say. One is definitely my daughter, who is a hero for sure, who always gets back up again. But the other one is Marge Wegman-Debris, who has believed in me since day one, and sometimes I have no idea why she has, but she has, and she's always been there to make sure that my dream keeps moving forward. So to me, that somebody, a hero to me, is somebody comes in and rescues when, you know, you're in the, you know, you're down in the dumps, or you really need somebody else to pick yourself up, and she's always there.
Excellent. And Marge was a black swan. So, well, Dianne, thank you so much for joining us on The Soul of Enterprise. I love your motto, Bookkeepers Unite. You have nothing to lose but your timesheets.
That's right. That's right. Exactly. Exactly.
So thank you very much for being a guest on The Soul of Enterprise.
Thank you, guys.